Okay, time to make the second application now. So hopefully you've done your hello purr and it all purrs when you click it and so on. What we're going to do now is go back to My Projects and create a new one, and this one we're going to call PicPaint, and this again it comes from the Google tutorials online. I just remembered that you have to make sure that there's no spaces. So once this opens up, we can do a few more things in this. And the idea with this application is that there'll be three buttons representing three colours along the top, and there'll be a canvas where the user can draw. There'll also be the ability to upload a picture and to draw over that picture, and also I'll put in something that shows you how to take a picture from the camera. You won't be able to use this in the emulator, but you would if you actually had an Android phone itself. So first things first, before we look at the blocks editor, is to make the screen. And one thing I'm going to do is change the title, because at the moment it says screen 1, which is a bit dull. Change this to PicPaint. And once we've done that, I'm going to put three buttons along the top, and they're going to go in a horizontal arrangement, which is going to go the entire width of the screen, and horizontally they're going to be aligned centre. If I leave it at the left for now and drag over the buttons, you'll see the effect of aligning them in the centre in just one moment. So this button here, this is going to be to make our text red. So under text over here, let's change this to red, and just to reinforce that, let's change the background colour to red too. Button 2, this is going to be for green, and again let's change that to green, and the last one is going to be blue, and change the text to blue. Now if you do this, you can't really see the black font, so we're going to change the text color there to white. So if we go back to the horizontal arrangement, at the moment horizontally aligned is left. If we choose center, that just neatens them up and puts them in the center of the screen. Before we go on, I'm just going to tidy up these names, because button 1, 2, 3, when we come to use the blocks editor, is going to get quite confusing. So click on button 1 and rename this to what it is, which is button red. Button 2, we're going to rename that to button green. And finally button 3, going to rename that to button blue. Next thing that goes down is our canvas, and a canvas is a blank area that the user can draw on, or that we can put animations on and so on. This canvas we want to be as wide as the screen, and the height, let's make it 200 pixels. Actually, let's make it a little bit bigger, let's make it 250. And the final thing we want down the bottom are three more buttons, which are going to say one to take a photo, one to use an image, and the other to just wipe the screen, to blank the screen. So exactly the same way that we did above, put in a horizontal arrangement, make it fill the whole parents, and we'll center align it. And the first thing we want is a button to take a photo, so put that in there, change the text to take photo. And while we're at it, we'll rename it to button photo. Next thing we want is a button to choose a picture. This isn't one of the actual buttons. If we go down to media, there's an inbuilt one called image picker, and if we choose that one, that will automatically go onto the gallery on the phone. So let's change the text there from text for image picker to choose photo, and let's rename that to button image picker. And the last thing to do is to go back and just a blank button to wipe the screen. Once we've done that, we're almost finished. The only other thing that we're going to need, oh, and I should just rename that to button wipe. The only other thing we're going to need later on is a photo, the ability to take a photo on here. So under Media, we go to Camera and just drag this over. And it's a non-visible component, so there's very little we can do here, but we will need that when we come to use the blocks editor, because that will enable us to use the blocks that use the camera part of the phone. So this is the complete front end. I'm going to open the blocks editor, but I'm going to stop this video, so if you go over to the next video, open the blocks editor, and we'll take it from there.